Nope, shotgun microphones are not good for voiceover work. They're great for voiceover work. So, there's been some misinformation going around about shotgun microphones. And to be clear, it's not that it's really misinformation, it's just misunderstanding information that's going around about shotgun microphones. So the misunderstood information that's going around is that shotgun microphones are not good for voiceover work because they don't perform well indoors and in small spaces. So I've had a few comments on my best microphone for voiceover video that were stating that shotgun microphones and the 416 are not good for voiceover work because they cause phase cancellation issues. Now, I won't name names here because I'm not trying to shame or embarrass anyone. I just want to set the record straight for shotgun microphones in voiceover. All right, so first things first, do voice actors actually use shotgun microphones for voiceover work?
I use a shotgun microphone for voiceover work.
I use a shotgun microphone for voiceover.
Pew pew.
I use a shotgun mic.
I use a shotgun mic for voiceover.
I use a shotgun microphone for voiceover work.
I use a shotgun mic for voiceover. Duh.
I use a shotgun microphone for voiceover.
I use a shotgun microphone for voiceover work.
Half, if not more than half, of professional voice actors use shotgun microphones as their primary microphone. But just to drive this home a little more, let's talk about the main person that made shotgun microphones so famous for voiceover work, specifically the Sennheiser 416. That person is Joe Cipriano. If you're in the voiceover community, you have definitely heard his name thrown around at one point or another. And if you're not in the voiceover community, you have definitely heard his voice at one point or another, whether you knew it or not. So let's just list a few of the things he's done. He's been the voice of the Fox TV network for 25 years and 20 years for the CBS network, and you've also heard him on NBC, ABC, CW, and many, many more. You get the idea. He's done a few things here and there. And as I said, what's the microphone he uses 99.9% of the time? The Sennheiser 416 shotgun microphone. Now, that should be really all the proof you need as to why shotgun microphones are one of the best choices for voiceover work, but for the sake of this video, I'm gonna keep going. So why would this misinformation, or really just misunderstood information, be going around about shotgun microphones not being good for voiceover work if half of the industry, if not more than half of the industry, use shotgun microphones for voiceover work? Well, it's mainly due to the fact that there's a lot of people who are just getting into voiceover and they're looking up information on YouTube, much like you are now. And because they don't know a whole lot about voiceover, they don't realize that in these videos, they're talking about how shotgun microphones indoors in a smaller reverberant space can cause phase cancellation issues with the microphone. The problem with this video or these videos isn't the information, and it's not the video itself, it's just the fact that the video isn't about recording voiceover. The video is more so about recording dialogue for like TV and film or talking head videos like YouTube videos, for example, like the one I'm recording right now. And like I said, the information in the video or these videos, it's correct. It's just the video's not about voiceover. Let me explain. If you're a professional voice actor, you're gonna make sure that the space you're recording in is professionally acoustically treated. Why is that important? Well, way too many reasons to get into for this video, but let's focus on the phase cancellation issue that people were talking about in the comments and in this video or these videos. But first, what is phase cancellation? Now, I'm not gonna get too deep into the weeds here or too technical because I don't wanna lose anybody, I don't wanna bore people, but long story short, the side grills on a shotgun microphone that you can see here are designed to reject audio from coming into the side of the microphone. Well, if you use this microphone in a smaller reverberant space, meaning that there are hard surfaces in that space, this will actually cause issues. So if you have the microphone in front of you, your voice is going to go directly into the microphone, which is good, obviously, that's the whole point. But these grills are designed to reject audio coming into the side of them. But the problem occurs when you're in such a small space with hard surfaces, your voice is gonna go into the microphone and then a split second later, it's gonna bounce off of the walls and come back into the side grills of this microphone. And because the space is so small and so reflective and the bounce back is so quick, it confuses the microphone and it can cause phase cancellation. Basically, you're gonna lose a lot of high-end content in your audio and it's gonna start to sound kind of muddy. But if you're a voice actor, you're not gonna have these issues. Why? Well, if you're a voice actor, you will have acoustically treated the space that you're recording in, and you will have stopped all of that hard surface reflection. That's the whole purpose of treating a space acoustically. You will have made sure that your voice isn't going to hit a hard surface and bounce back into the microphone. So we don't have to worry about these issues with shotgun microphones. The other point that this video and these videos are trying to make is that longer shotgun microphones, like the Rode NTG-8, for example, are actually going to have worse phase cancellation issues due to the fact that the shotgun microphone is even longer, which will cause worse phase canceling issues, and you will actually not only lose high-end content, but you'll start to lose low-end content as well. This would be a problem if, one, voice actors didn't professionally acoustically treat the space that they're recording in, and two, we actually used long specialty shotgun microphones, but we don't. Now, as I said before, these grills on the side of the microphone is what causes these phase cancellation issues in smaller reverberant spaces. But what's funny is these grills are actually the reason that shotgun microphones end up being so awesome for voiceover work. Think about it. After voice actors have professionally treated their space and they've minimized the hard surface reflection, these grills actually become amazing for us. The polar pattern of this microphone is extremely tight, which is awesome because it's gonna pick up what's right in front of the microphone and everything else is going to reject. So if I'm recording in my space and I have the mic like this and I'm talking, it's gonna pick up what's right in front of it, which would be my mouth, my voice, and then everything around it, it's going to reject. And if my space is professionally acoustically treated, my voice isn't gonna be bouncing back off the walls and into the mic. And because of this, it's going to make a tighter sound. So I've said this in a few of my other videos, but I had a student send me some audio and they recorded it on two microphones. They recorded take one on a Sennheiser 416, and they recorded take two on a TLM 103. Now, they didn't tell me which take was which, so when they sent the takes over to me, they weren't labeled, and I listened to them, and I immediately could tell which one was the Sennheiser 416 and which one was the TLM 103. The 416 sounded very, very tight. I could not hear the room. I couldn't hear room reflection. It sounded really good. The TLM 103, I could hear the room. It started to sound a little reflective. And just a little bonus bit of advice, a TLM 103 and a Neumann U87 were not designed for smaller spaces. So if you are in a booth, a very small booth, like a 4x4 booth or a tiny closet, which I have a tiny closet at home, if you're using a TLM 103 or a Neumann U87, stop. Change out that microphone to something else, like a shotgun microphone. Because what ends up happening is your audio sounds boomy, it sounds muddy, and it could potentially sound boxy because they're not designed for small spaces. They can't handle that small space. It's almost like it's suffocating those microphones. So long story short, yes, these phase cancellation issues are real issues, and they do happen and they can happen. It's just, this is more so for capturing audio for TV and film and talking head videos like YouTube, even though I'm actually using a shotgun microphone right now and there's a lot of hard surface reflection in this space, but we're just gonna pretend like I'm not. But this channel is about voiceover work. It's not about recording dialogue for film and TV and stuff like that. It's about voiceover. So these are not issues for us. These aren't things that we need to worry about because we're gonna make sure as voice actors that the space that we record in is professionally acoustically treated. Now, if you want to make money in voiceover, the space that you record in, your home studio, needs to sound like that of a professional studio. If you're lacking in this area, you're gonna dramatically cut down on the amount of jobs you could have booked and the amount of money you could have made. If you'd like help building and treating your home studio, I'll leave multiple links below where you can set up a time with me and we can do so. If you'd like help with recording your audio and making sure it sounds as professional as it possibly can, and really just how to record and edit in your DAW, I'll leave links below for that as well, because I teach all of that. You can also check out all of our on-demand voiceover courses over at provoiceovertraining.com. That'll be the first link in this video. And if you're local, stop by Atlanta Voiceover Studio or join one of our live classes that you can take in person with us or over Zoom, so you can take it wherever you're from. I really hope this video was helpful and informative, and if it wasn't, well, you know what they say.
I use a shotgun knife. I use a shotgun, what is it? Oh.
Hey, I don't know if you noticed, but I use a shotgun microphone for voiceover. It's German. It's a German microphone.
What are you? I'm a Sennheiser. I'm a Sennheiser microphone. You want to use me? You can. If you don't, I don't care. You want to use a Neumann? We're all German. Only the good microphones are German. I don't think it's like that anymore. Oh, shush it. All the German microphones are good.